There's a moment in every pilot's journey when the sky doesn't give you a straight path. Maybe air traffic control needs more spacing, maybe weather blocks your arrival, or maybe something unexpected shows up. When that happens, one maneuver becomes your lifeline and your compass in helping manage the chaos. Today, we're taking a closer look at holding patterns. What they are, when you'll use them, and why it matters so much in IFR flying, and how mastering them becomes a defining skill on your instrument rating check ride. Before we begin, make sure you like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel to catch even more aviation tips and insights from Epic Flight Academy. Let's get started. So, what is a holding pattern? Think of it as a controlled pause in the sky, a precise racetrack pattern flown around a specific fix or waypoint. Air traffic control may assign it for spacing, weather delays, altitude restrictions, or as part of a missed approach. You'll fly an inbound leg to the fix, turn outbound, then loop back to repeat the course until you're cleared to continue. Sometimes the hold is published right on the approach chart, and other times, air traffic control assigns an unpublished hold on the spot as part of your clearance. Either way, it's your job to fly it smoothly, accurately, and confidently. Now that we know what a holding pattern is, the next step is understanding how to enter one. The FAA recognizes three standard entry methods, and choosing the right one depends entirely on your heading as you approach the fix. This is where precision meets instinct, because on a check ride or a real IFR flight, you're expected to identify the correct entry quickly and confidently. A direct entry is used when you're approaching the fix head-on. You fly straight to the fix, then turn to join the holding pattern without any extra maneuvering. A parallel entry is used when you're approaching from the opposite side. You cross the fix, turn to fly parallel to the outbound course, then circle back around to re-intercept to the pattern. A teardrop entry, also called an offset entry, is used when you're approaching at an angle. You cross the fix, make a 30-degree turn away from the inbound course, and then turn back in to intercept the hold. The AIM provides diagrams to help visualize these, but over time, you'll learn to recognize the correct entry almost instantly. That skill matters. It's tested on the instrument check ride, and even more importantly, it's something you'll use in real IFR conditions when timing, accuracy, and calm decision-making are everything. Once you're established in the hold, the pattern itself follows a set of rules designed to keep you safe and inside protected airspace. Most holds use standard right turns, but you'll occasionally see non-standard left turns published on charts or assigned by air traffic control. The direction matters because every hold is built around specific terrain and airspace requirements, so flying the wrong turn can take you outside of where you're protected. Timing plays a big role. Below 14,000 feet, each leg of the hold is typically flown for 1 minute. Above 14,000 feet, it increases to 1.5 minutes. Real-world conditions rarely give you calm, steady winds, so you'll apply wind correction on both legs to keep the pattern tight and properly aligned. Pilots adjust their headings and refine their outbound timing to ensure they return to the fix exactly when planned. It's a small detail that makes a huge difference in precision flying. Although holding patterns are mainly used in IFR operations, VFR pilots practice them during training as well. It builds strong situational awareness, prepares students for future instrument training, and helps every Epic pilot develop stronger control, timing, and navigation skills. Entering holding patterns requires calm, precise decision-making. Air traffic control may use holds to manage traffic at busy airports, spacing arriving aircraft safely. Some of the most common reasons include traffic delays near congested airspace, missed approach procedures, lost comms situations, navigational reorientation, emergency procedures, and weather-related delays. Epic instructors always stress one key rule. Your job is to follow air traffic control's instructions exactly as given, and to understand what the FAA expects from you in every hold. The Aeronautical Information Manual, Section 5-3-7, lays out the full procedures, and it's a resource every instrument pilot should know well. Every holding pattern is built around a specific point in space, and that point is defined by a NAVAID. These navigation aids act as the anchor point of the entire maneuver, giving pilots the reference they need to stay aligned, precise, and inside protected airspace. Depending on the clearance, aircraft type, and available equipment, a holding fix can be created using several different NAVAIDs. Here are the most common ones you'll use. VOR provides a magnetic course to or from the station. Many holds are flown directly over or around a VOR, making it one of the most common fixes used in IFR operations. NDB transmits a low-frequency, non-directional signal that the aircraft tracks using the ADF. Although less common today, NDB holds still appear on some charts and checkride scenarios. DME measures the slant range distance to a ground station. When paired with a VOR, DME helps define a fix using both bearing and distance, allowing air traffic control to assign precise holding points. VORTAC. These are stations that combine a VOR with distance information. They let pilots know both the direction to the station and how far away they are. This makes them easy and reliable holding fixes. No matter which NAVAID defines the fix, its purpose is the same. It keeps your aircraft anchored to a known point, ensuring the holding pattern stays predictable, repeatable, and safe. Flight simulators make holding pattern practice safer, easier, and far more efficient. Epic students use our sims to build muscle memory with entries, timing, and radio clearances long before applying those skills in the air. Simulators help pilots practice how to read and interpret chart depictions, apply correct entry procedures, maintain proper pattern length and position, and execute holding clearance instructions under time pressure. This training is essential for instrument students. It sharpens checkride readiness, builds confidence, and prepares pilots for the complex IFR environments they'll experience during real-world flying. Holding patterns themselves are safe, standard procedures, but when they combine with other issues like weather, miscommunication, or fuel limits, they can become contributing factors in serious incidents. Many past accidents linked to holds weren't caused by the maneuver itself, but by the challenges surrounding it. That's why situational awareness, clear communication, and strong decision-making are essential. Here are some factors that contribute to holding pattern accidents. Fuel mismanagement. Aircraft can run dangerously low on fuel while holding, especially if pilots delay declaring a fuel emergency or fail to plan for extended delays. Communication errors. Misheard, unclear, or incomplete exchanges between pilots and air traffic control can lead to incorrect entries, wrong altitudes, or missed critical information. Weather conditions. Poor visibility, storms, or wind shear can trigger initial holds and then add pressure on the crew, raising workload and risk during later approaches. Crew errors. Distraction, high workload, or poor task prioritization can lead to missed fuel checks, incorrect timing, or failure to exit the hold when needed. Controller errors. Air traffic control may give incorrect instructions, misjudge spacing, or fail to provide updates that pilots need to safely manage the hold. Mastering these holding patterns and procedures helps pilots prevent accidents, meet FAA expectations, and fly with confidence, even when delays, weather, or unexpected challenges show up. When you understand holding patterns, you are not just following instructions. You are navigating with precision, awareness, and the mindset of a true instrument pilot. Thanks for watching. If you learned something new, leave a like on this video and make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel for even more aviation tips and insights from Epic Flight Academy.